We now want to do a very simple test. Remember when we looked at nutrition, we said for us to make sure that photosynthesis is occurred, we must be able to test for the products of photosynthesis. So today we want to test these leaves which I have here. We want to test them for starch. This one, nicely colored, yellow color and green. We refer to this as a variegated leaf. Remember, chlorophyll is the green pigment, which means the yellow, something else, nicely green. So we are going to do the steps. I hope you still remember. So first, we are going to dip these leaves in what? Water. We have created, this is a water bath. We have boiled this water for some time. So we are going just to dip these ones in here for a few minutes. Remember, this first dipping, we want to stop all chemical reactions. Thus, we are going to kill the cells. And when we say we kill the cells, we have destroyed the enzymes, the process which we refer to as denaturation. This process also breaks the cuticle. All leaves have a waxy layer, which is waterproof. This process will break that cuticle as well, so that the reactions which will follow can now take place more readily. Okay, so I think this process is okay. We don't need to boil them for a long time. Now I'm going to remove the leaves from the hot water. I'm simply using a rod. Okay. And I'm going now to place them in a boiling tube. Let's take this nice colored one. There you go. Okay. And a small one. Some leaves are a bit difficult to remove their chlorophyll. That's why I'm using a collection of them. Okay. Now we need to add the alcohol. And we said at this stage there's a safety measure which we must do. Down there, the burner is on. But we said alcohol is highly flammable. So we must put off the burner flame before we proceed. Okay, so I'm now going to put off the burner flame. Okay. Now I'm going to add alcohol. Let me put this in a bit down so that you don't use too much alcohol. Okay, covering them up completely. Now put in a water bath. Alcohol does not need any direct heating for it to boil, because our water is already boiled. It means roughly the boiling point of water is about 100 degrees, but the boiling point of alcohol is about 78 degrees. So the water at a temperature of 100 should be able to cause the alcohol to boil. And I'm sure you can see that already the boiling has started. So let's just wait and observe. So during this process, we are going to remove the chlorophyll. We must remove the chlorophyll from the leaves. The reason why we need to remove the chlorophyll is so that the observation, the color changes which will occur during the starch test will be more clear for us to observe. Okay, so the alcohol is boiling. Let's just wait a bit and see. About 5 minutes. So bear with me for about 5 minutes as this one boils. Thank you for your patience. So let's see, 5 minutes up. Let's see. We are now going to remove our leaves from the alcohol. Okay. Remember, I said some leaves, their chlorophyll is a bit difficult to remove. So there you go. Okay. Another one. There you go. and the other one, there you go. Second dipping. I'll use this one to explain why we need the second dipping. I'll demonstrate with this one before I dip it. Okay, there you go. But can you see the color of the alcohol? We started with the purple, but it's now a different color altogether. This is now because the chlorophyll, the green pigment, was getting into the alcohol. So if we had used the colorless alcohol, the color we should have been able to see the green color more easily. This one is, it's greenish, but it's now mixed with the purple. Okay, that's why we said the alcohol is not the one which will end up with the color. Okay, this third stage, why we need to in water again is because when you boil the leaf in alcohol, it makes it a bit brittle, so it's now a bit hard. You can see it breaks very easily. Okay, but after dipping it, you soften the leaves. Okay, so I've dipped my leaves. Just takes a minute. Okay, so we've softened the leaves, making them easier to spread and also making them more permeable to our iodine, which is used to test for starch. Wow, this is nice. This one is okay, so we now spread on a white tile to make the observations more easily. Okay, let's also place our this one, but because the chlorophyll was not completely removed, you are going to see what you're going to see there. Okay, that's the reason why we say we must remove the chlorophyll. Okay, so this is our iodine, and this is my dropper. We call it a pipette dropper. So I'm going to flood this one with iodine solution. Okay. And we said if starch is present, it should turn to a dark blue-black color. You should observe a blue-black color. Okay. And the amount, how dark the leaf was at the beginning, gives us a measure of the concentration of the chlorophyll on your leaf. Okay. So we've added the leaves. So where did the photosynthesis really occur? In this leaf, blend of it, and it is this leaf here. This is the same one. Okay, blue-black color. I hope you can see the blue-black color. It was whitish after removing chlorophyll. Then we added the iodine, and this is the color that it ended up with. This one also managed to turn blue-black. But this one, the color chlorophyll was not completely removed, which means the breaking of the cuticle was a bit difficult, so you cannot observe much. Then with this variegated leaf, this one is quite interesting. Though the color is developing, it's coming out nicely, though it's taking its time. Okay. But let's see. I have the same, more or less of the same leaf there, but it was more or less like this one. Can you see where the blue-black color is? These regions where there is, which was marked green. But the yellow edges, nothing. It's just turned yellow brown, which is basically the color of our iodine. It did not turn blue black. So, what are the conclusions that you can make? Because these leaves, they turned blue black, it means starch is present, which means we can conclude that this plants were able to photosynthesize. Okay, this one, the region which turned blue black had chlorophyll. The one which was yellow in color did not turn blue black, the edges did not turn blue black, which means for photosynthesis to occur, chlorophyll is necessary. Okay, so the other requirements, carbon dioxide, light, you can perform the same experiments, and we are going to discuss how we can do these experiments later on. But the testing for starch, basically at the end of the day, this is the same. So when we say now test for starch, this is how you test for your starch. Thank you. Please remember, subscribe, like and share if you find this video helpful. Thank you.